السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. We are meeting today, inshallah, for a fruitful and hopefully for a beneficial meeting for all of us. So I'm saying, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. This is intended to bless the meeting. Yes, Mama Habiba, what are we going to talk about today?
Sheikh, so many people wonder about love. You hear about love in films.
Well, that's a big subject.
Wow. In songs, in literature. What is the best way to get into the subject, to find the essentials, the essential meaning of love?
Mama Habiba, you should tell us about this. Your name is Habiba, the beloved. Mama Habiba.
I'll listen to it from you, Sheikh.
Inshallah, inshallah. We cannot turn down the suggestion from Mama Habiba. Subhanallah, we are in month of Sha'ban, the month just before Ramadan. It is called the month of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or the month of beloved one. And in traditional revelation, traditional spirituality, it is the month of love. It is the month of healing of hearts. It is the month of hope. Love is not a luxury. This is first thing we have to write down and underline it many times. Love is not a luxury. Love is not something we good people have. No, it's for everybody. Absolutely. This world was created from an intention of love by the divine. Allah Azza wa Jal says, I was a hidden treasure and I wanted to be known. I loved to be known. So I created a human to be my mirror. And the master of all humanity, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of his higher names is Al-Habib, the beloved one. Allah Azza wa Jal in many hadith Qudusi address Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through names of love. Divine names, as we know in Islamic revelation, 99 names. 99 names, 50 names are names of beauty, we say. Means names of love. And even the 49 names of majesty, we call them Jalal names, are also, there is in them such underlying meanings of love. Love is, we cannot run away from it. Because foundation of humanity is to continue progeny. And progeny, children, come from meeting of men and women, that is love. Even in English, they say when a man and woman meet in very intimate meeting, they say they make love. So the earth, the very matter from which life is made, is made of love. Love is when we want to be better than ourselves. Love is when we are able to transcend ourselves, because humans, each one of us, is unique. We are each one world, one independent universe from other people. But we are able to cross to other people through love. That's why calculations and strategy, we call them mind games. Mind games. It is just to win a situation. While love, we say, is from the heart. And we, as humans, we link it to everything that is very dear to us. We say love of parents. We say, you know, in the poetry, Farhat and Shirin and such, Qais and Layla, and it's the highest infatuation with beauty and the highest emotion in our hearts, we call it love. So much so that Rasulullah Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he called, he said, if you die from love, from ishq, infatuation of love, strong love, you are a shaheed. He said those, because people may, in their hearts, to have such an emotion of love, and in a separation from that love, they may die. Rasulullah said that's one type of shahada, of being a martyr. Subhanallah. And love is an energy. An energy proceeding from Allah Azza wa Jal to the heart of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and from his holy heart to the hearts of humanity. You cannot control it, you cannot buy it, you cannot sell it, you cannot keep it, no. So one of the highest manifestations of the divine, of Allah Azza wa Jal, manifestation of Allah, is that invisible energy that goes, and therefore it goes only to a heart ready for that. It's the same story as Iman, as belief, is the, because they go together, in fact. These are the energies of life and the energies of eternity. That's why for eternity, paradise is a place of love. So let me make clear this point, because it's the highest point about love. That is not something we choose, or something only for some people, or something only in some situations. No. That's why in all time they say, listen to your heart. You know, some people say, I have love on Friday to give sadaqah, to give charity. But when I am in my work, work is professional. We tell people, if you include love in your professionality, you will be successful 10 times more and more. As Allah Azza wa Jal says, one good deed is 10 times rewarded. And that's why I remember Jack Ma, he's Muslim, subhanAllah, from Jiahui. He's the richest man in China. He says he now he's doing much charity work, and he gives some talks to help young entrepreneurs. As I know, many people in Kazakhstan, in Central Asia, are now young people into entrepreneurship. He says, he was asked, how did you make this much fortune? He said, by sharing. I share. He said, you become successful when you give, not when you take. No, when you give. So that's part, that's, see why Islam is one, or revelation, or spirituality is way of happiness. We talk about love also, we end up talking about happiness. So love is an energy seeping through hearts. And it makes people who are alike to connect. It makes destinies to meet. It makes the biggest miracle on face of earth, which is children, to come. It makes happiness to enter the heart and to inhabit our lives. So it's an energy that is beyond what we think about when we say love. Oh, love, we think mostly man loves a woman, or I love my country, or in most of these times is emotions. But when we talk about love, we're talking about an energy, not just an emotion, an energy. And that energy, yes, that energy is beyond our control, but we can help it be by cleaning our hearts, by cleaning our intentions. That's why you find these feelings of happiness and peace, which are linked to love, you find them with good people. Yes, Mama Habiba, I think you have a question.
Love is all around you, Sheikh, mashallah.
Love, 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 love. Sweet love.
Oh, yeah. What then would be your practical advice for people in a relationship? How is it best for them to approach this matter of love and to have that love grow and become stronger and stronger?
She asks always big questions. We try to answer. We said earlier that the gentleman advisor of success said, Allah bless him, said that to be successful, you have to share and give. Also, love is you accept to give from yourself or even to give yourself. So love is founded on self, on generosity. I was going to say self-sacrifice, but that's higher degrees of love. Generosity. For example, in the family or in the couple, love is built on, what does this mean? It means you close your eyes when you see something wrong. You forgive. You are patient. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said it for all believers because he said believers are brothers and sisters. And brothers and sisters is built on love, the relationship. He said, find for the mistake 70 excuses. And tell yourself there's always another excuse you don't know. So in the couple, for instance, because that's the easiest example of love, is the most obvious example of love or lack thereof. Because many couples today, there is lack of love. Why? Because there is the opposite to love. Egoism, egotism. Egoism. Ego, because love is energy of the soul. Opposite to the soul is the ego, nafs al-ammara bisu, the ego which orders always badness and orders always, ego orders always selfishness, gives always bad interpretations. Big example of ego, Pharaoh, Fir'aun. Ego is violent. Ego is not generous, is greedy, cupid, selfish. That's ego. When people forget that there is ego, then their ego runs amok, runs doing everything. And when people especially don't know or forget that ego is the opposite of love, then they lose love from their environment. So love, for love to be, ego has to be controlled. In general life, it's a hard thing to do. But when your heart is really in love, it's easy to control your ego. Because you want to give everything to the other person. So you don't give much to your ego. But we think always that in life we have to develop the capacity to forgive. To forgive. Al-musamaha. To forgive. the capacity to find excuses for people. You know, when you hear in history of Islam, Sayyidina Umar was like this, Sultan Sulaiman was like that. They were like that only in Sharia, for in the law, yani as a judge, they were strong. But in social life and in family life and in brotherhood life and in neighborhood life, they were very easy people because they had the akhlaq of Prophet ﷺ. Now we notice why Allah called Rasulullah ﷺ, Sayyidina Muhammad. He called him the beloved one, Al-Habib, because he was the fountainhead, the fountainhead. He was the ocean of love. He taught. All of his teaching is how to be in love, how to love others, how to love the nation, the humanity, the nation of believers, how to love your motherland, how to love your family, how to love your neighborhood, how to love your brothers and sisters, how to love your mate, your wife, your husband, your children, how to love Prophet, how to love Allah Azza wa Jal, how to love eternity, how to love yourself. Then it's a love that is not egoism, is not egotism, because egoism is selfishness to oneself. But loving yourself means putting yourself, putting ourselves on the path of happiness. And real happiness is the happiness that is in this world and hereafter. So it's path of belief. So one of the biggest gates of love is faith. That's why in the beginning we said it's same energy proceeding from the same place. Energy is different energy proceeding from the same place, but eventually they become one energy. Energy of faith. That's why believers are, they love, they're people of love. That's why believers, they love people before themselves. They share, they give. So while love, we think about love as love of emotions, idea of love is even more hidden in charity, in social responsibility. You know, social responsibility is not a stiff, square idea, no. Social responsibility is love of people around you. So you don't want to see somebody hungry. You don't want to see somebody suffering. If you can help them, you help. That goes around all that good choices. They come around to inhabit our very life. That's why we hear how Umna Khadija, our mother Khadija, wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how good she was, how patient she was, how supportive of Rasulullah. We hear about Umna Aisha, we hear about Umna Fatima, daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we hear about all the great ones of Islam, and we hear about our mother Maryam alayhi salam. So it is something to be, is multiple streams of income. It's multiple streams of happiness. That's what it is. It comes from every side, you know. And obviously, most important space of love today is the immediate family. The immediate family, with the wife, with the husband, with the brothers and sisters, with the parents. Yes, Mama Habiba. Yes, yes, yes. Ask and you get.
give us more love. Hey. Yeah.
Sweet love.
Oh, yeah.
this is end of times, sheikhs of the end of times. Like this. Yes, mother.
Can you give us a dua for more no. love?
Before dua, we have to talk about dua of the family, in the family.
Okay.
In the family. And this responsibility is, first of all, to the husbands and wife. To the wife, we say, keep your tongue, control. Don't nag the man. Why I say to the wife? Because ladies, they have this power of observation, of criticism, of... So lady has to be patient that way. Man, you have to be patient because you are the captain. You have to be loving, understanding, patient, forgiving. You have to think. You have to understand about people, children, wife, parents, neighbors. And you have to teach in your family. You are the first responsible in teaching to the couple. And the wife is first responsible for teaching to the children. And in the families, love is not only the emotion between the couple. Avoid in the families to speak about people. Avoid to speak about negative things. Avoid to mention negative situations you saw. Avoid to bring old stuff. This is all shaitan. Shaitan is the opposite to love. He's a friend of the ego. Tries always to throw things in the middle. You don't allow that. Don't let shaitan in. You feel agitated by something, go drink a glass of cold water. Make wudu, make ablution, abdest. Go outside. Once, Sayyidina Umar, second Khalifa of Islam, was known to be very strong personality, very, very strong, intimidating to all men. So once, Sayyidina Abu Bakr, radiallahu anhu, was very soft, was in the heat of the day, very hot day in the middle of the day. He found Sayyidina Umar sitting in front of his house. He said, Ya Umar, radiallahu anhu, Ya Umar, it's so hot. Why don't you go inside in the shade? It's too hot outside. He told him, no. Umm Abdullah is his wife of Sayyidina Umar. Umm Hafsa, Umm Abdullah. He told him, Umm Abdullah, she's not happy. She's angry at me. So I'm waiting till she cools down. After I go in the house. So he did not say she's wrong. No, he said she is a little bit, I'm waiting. Yeah. Find excuses for people. You will see the magic of it. You find excuses for people, people find excuses for you. Much more even. And love to the motherland, love to the country, love to your faith. It's important because that's your identity. And that's what makes you to be connected to your society and to make you a fruitful and happy citizen. This is also very important. So you see, People think love is an emotion between men and women, or an emotion even in the family. No, it's an energy just like the soul. The soul, ruh, is an energy in the heart. It's not an emotion like this, flying emotion. No, it's as basic as shahada to say la ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. And look at this. Allah put the name of the beloved, Sayyidina Muhammad, next to his name, said la ilaha illallah Muhammad. Next, Rasulullah. It's as if Allah is saying, the way to me is through my beloved one. ومن الله التوفيق الفاتحة الحمد لله رب العالمين. ماما حبيبة. What is the dessert on our menu today?
Love upon love upon love upon love.
Love, 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 love. Not crazy love, sweet love. ماما حبيبة سجست ومك دعاء. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد القائل يوم اللقاء أمتي أمتي وأمتاه وعلى آله وصحبه من والاه. اللهم يا رب بجاه حبيبك المصطفى ونبيك المرتضى وأمينك على أماناتها الأرض والسماء نسألك اللهم أن لا تدع لا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا هما إلا فرجته ولا حاجة هي لك رضا إلا سهلتها يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اهدنا واهدي بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. اللهم استرنا بسترك الجميل واستر عوراتنا وآمن روعاتنا واقض لنا ديوننا يا ودود يا ذو العرش المجيد يا فعال لما يريد يا من جلاله لا يرام وملكه لا يضام نوره ملا أركان عرشه. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وتب علينا واهدنا واسقنا واصلح شأننا وشأن المسلمين وصلنا على القوم الظالمين وانصر سلطان وسلطان المسلمين. O our Lord, we ask you for the honor of your beloved one, by the honor of your beloved one, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We ask you to fill our hearts with happiness, with peace, with honor. Ya Rabbi, ya Allah, make us from those who are successful in dunya and akhirah. O Allah, we ask you to bless our parents and our teachers and our ancestors and our country. We ask you to bless our land. We ask you, Ya Rabbi, to give us right guidance. We ask you, Ya Rabbi, to protect our children. We ask you, Ya Rabbi, for our graves to be gardens of paradise. We ask you, Ya Rabbi, for the end of our life to be happy end. We ask you, Ya Rabbi, to be among those who are successful in this life and in the hereafter. We ask you to live on Islam and die on Iman. And be resurrected with the good ones. We ask also for all humanity, as they are our brothers and sisters in humanity. We ask for them right guidance, healing, and hope. We ask for our brothers and sisters in faith, in Islam, and in motherland. We ask for them blessings, 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 Ya Rabbi. We ask for all of us healing of our hearts, minds, and bodies. We ask for everybody, Ya Rabbi, to be fulfilled with peace, with tranquility, with love. And Ya Rabbi Allah, put us in the heart of your loved ones. Sayyidina Ahmed Al-Yasawi, Sayyidina Shahan Naqshband, Sayyidina Abdul Khaliq Al-Ghujdwani, Sadatna Ahlullah, all holy ones, and especially in the heart of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. لله تعالى الفاتحة. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الرحمن الرحيم. مالك يوم الدين. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. Thank you so much to be with us. Thank you so much to, إن شاء الله this meeting was a fruitful meeting. إن شاء الله there are some inspirations which are good for our hearts, and some inshallah of these words may find the fruit now or later. Don't worry, some of these words come into our hearts and becomes a fruit, inshallah. May Allah Azza wa Jalla bless you all. Please keep the intention of love and the intention of happiness. and the intention of sharing. Wa min Allah al-tawfiq al-fatiha. My highest prayer to the soul of our beloved Shaykh Mawlana Shaykh Nazim and all those who have rights upon us, who taught us. Fatiha. Salamu alaykum, sweet love.